Welcome all. In this video, we are going to solve some simple examples of a periodicity of a signal. So for given signals, we are going to check whether these signals are periodic or non-periodic signal. And if it is periodic, what is its fundamental period? So let's start one by one to solve these examples. First example, x of t is equals to 5 cos of 200 pi t. Now to check periodicity of a signal, we will compare given equation with standard cosine signal. That is, x of t is equals to a cos of 2 pi f 0 t. Then we will get two pi f zero is equals to 200 pi. If we simplify this equation for the frequency f zero, we will get 200 pi upon 2 pi. Simplifying this, we'll get fundamental frequency f0 is equals to 100 Hz. Now we know that fundamental period of a signal is reciprocal of fundamental frequency f0. Therefore, t0 is equals to 1 upon 100. 1 upon 100 is nothing but 0.01 second. If we convert it into the millisecond, it will be 10 milliseconds. As given signal has time period t0, 10 milliseconds, we can say that given signal is periodic with period t0 is equals to 10 milliseconds. Next example, x of n is equals to 12 sine of 25 pi n. Now, here given signal is discrete time signal. We know that the condition for discrete time signal to be periodic is f0 is equals to k by n, that is, frequency should be a ratio of two integers, where n represents the period of a discrete time signal. Now comparing given signal x of n with standard sine wave signal, that is, x of n is equals to a sine of 2 pi f 0 n. We will get 2 pi f 0 is equals to 25 pi. Now if we simplify this equation, for f0, we will get 25 pi divided by 2 pi. That is, f0 is equals to 25 upon 2. That is, the frequency f0 is ratio of integers k upon n. Hence, we can say that given signal x of n is periodic with period capital N is equal to 2 samples per cycle. The denominator of frequency represents the period capital N. Next example is x of n is equals to 9 cos of 25 n. Given signal x of n is discrete time signal, and we know the condition for discrete time signal. It is periodic if frequency f0 is equals to k by n, that is ratio of two integers. Therefore, if we compare given signal x of n with standard cosine signal, we will get 2 pi f0 is equals to 25. Simplifying this for f0, we will get 25 upon 2 pi. Now here, pi is not an integer. So frequency f0 is not a ratio of k by n. That is, it is not a ratio of two integers. Hence, given signal x of n is non-periodic signal. Next example, x of t is equals to cos square 2 pi t. Now here, given signal x of t is not in the form of standard sine or cosine. So we cannot calculate the frequency directly. So this cos square term we have to convert into the simple sine or cosine term. So we know the standard equation for cos square theta. One plus cos of 2 theta is equals to 2 cos square theta. That means cos square theta is equals to 1 plus cos of 2 theta divided by 2. Applying this formula of cos square theta to the given signal x of t, we will get x of t is equals to x of t is equals to 1 plus cos of 2 into 2 pi t divided by 2. Simplifying this and separating the denominator, 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 cos of 4 pi t. That is, x of t is equals to 0.5 plus 0.5 cos of 4 pi t. Now here, in this equation, first term, that is 0.5, is a DC term. It does not have any frequency component. But second term, which is a standard cosine term, is having frequency component. So comparing with the standard cosine, we'll get 2 pi f0 is equals to 4 pi. That is, f0 is equals to 4 pi upon 2 pi. If we simplify this, f0 is equals to 2 hertz. We know the fundamental period of continuous time signal t0 is reciprocal of fundamental frequency f0. That is, t0 is equals to 1 upon 2, which will be 0.5 second. That means given signal x of t is periodic with period t0 is equals to 0.5 second. Next example, x of t is equals to 4 cosine of pi by 100 t plus 2 cosine of 2 pi by 180 t. Now given continuous time signal x of t is of the form x of t is equals to x1 of t plus x2 of t. Where x1 of t is equals to 4 cos pi by 100 t and x2 of t is equals to 2 cos 2 pi by 180 t. For x1 of t, we'll get 2 pi f1 is equals to pi by 100. Simplifying this, f1 is equals to pi by 100 into 1 upon 2 pi. That means f1 is equals to 1 upon 200. Time period t1 is reciprocal of frequency, so it will be 1 upon 1 by 200. That means t1 is equals to 200 second. Similarly, for x2 of t, 2 pi f2 is equals to 2 pi by 180. Simplifying this for f2, we will get f2 is equals to 2 pi by 180 into 1 upon 2 pi. 2 pi will get cancelled and f2 will be 1 upon 180. Fundamental period t2 is reciprocal of f2. If we put the value of f2, we will get period t2 is equals to 180 second. That means x1 of t and x2 of t both are periodic, hence given signal x of t is periodic if it satisfies the condition T1 by T2 is equals to N upon M, that is ratio of integers. If this condition is satisfied, given signal x of t will be periodic. So if you put the values of T1 and T2, that is 200 upon 180, after simplifying we'll get 10 upon 9, that is ratio of integers. Hence x of t is periodic and period t of x of t is given by t is equals to LCM of T1 and T2. Now to calculate the LCM, we'll use lambda method, that is period t is equals to lambda 1 into T1 equals to lambda 2 into T2. That is nothing but lambda 1 upon lambda 2 is equals to T2 upon T1. If you put the values of periods, we'll get lambda 1 upon lambda 2 is equals to 9 upon 10. That means lambda 1 is 9 and lambda 2 is equals to 10. If you put these values, we'll get period T is equals to lambda 1 9 and period T1 is 200. So total period T is 1800 seconds. That means given signal x of t is periodic with period t is equals to 1800 seconds. Try to solve these examples as a practice. You can mention your answers in a comment section. If you are having difficulty to solve any of these examples, you can mention it in a comment box. Thank you for watching the video.